That's not what I said,
Andy. No, you're missing the
point. I said she was big enough so you can stick his dick inside. That's what I'm saying.
Spartan.
Let's not lie and say I said adult. You said I said adult. I did not say adult. Nowhere did I say. So please take down the video or correct it. That's all I'm saying. Be consistent. You said I said adult. I didn't say adult.
If you're going to say that the Prophet Muhammad is not a prophet because of this, you need to say bye-bye to Jesus. Because Jesus tells you to smash babies according to rocks.
No,
it tells you to rape women.
It doesn't.
Yes, it does. It tells you
new covenant. I've told you this already.
So, one second.
And by the way, you using
the
Old
Testament
goes against you.
You should say bye-bye to your God.
Because in the truth, according to the Quran, the children of Israel have a covenant.
Shouldn't you say bye-bye to your God?
According to the Quran, the children of Israel, Surah Al-Baqarah, the children of Israel have a covenant. Yes or no?
They broke the covenant.
Yes, they broke the covenant.
Yes, and that's why God punished them.
Yes, that's right.
So if someone leaves Islam, what's the punishment?
The punishment is
burning. What's the punishment for a Muslim? Yeah, well, if he leaves Islam, what's his punishment?
What's the punishment? Are you a Christian?
Yes, what's his punishment?
Yeah, what's the punishment in Christianity? What's his punishment?
Same thing.
No,
what's his punishment in Christianity?
Old covenant.
What's his punishment for Deuteronomy?
Old covenant.
What's his
punishment for Deuteronomy? In the book of Deuteronomy, as a Christian, if you worship another God, you'll be killed.
For the Israelites, Ali. Not for me. I'm trying to be as calm as I can with you, but you're not being honest. You're not being honest. You're not being consistent.
Tell me how
you feel. My faith does not rely upon the old covenant, the old covenant or the Old Testament. My faith relies solely on the New Testament and the new covenant that is with Christ, in Christ's blood, according to Luke 22.
Okay. Right,
so if you go to the Old Testament, I'm just going to tell you the same thing, because none of that matters to me. It's not for me, it's for those people at that time, given at that time to turn those people, a barbaric nation, into a better nation.
By killing men, women, children, donkeys, and babies.
No, bro, we've taken 1 Samuel 15 out of place.
No, is that happened? Did that happen?
So what happened before that?
No, but did that happen?
Yes, it happened.
Okay, good.
What's happened
so in the book of 1 Samuel, chapter
1. Bro, what happened? Ali, please, be consistent, bro. Okay, let's go to Surah 99, yeah, and say that.
Stand here, because I can't understand you.
Okay, let's go to Surah 99. When in Surah 99 it says, fight the unbelievers.
Listen, do you want to talk about this?
Let's
have a similar discussion.
I'm having a similar discussion.
You can't just take it
like that.
Use it for the love of God.
Well,
is it
going to
take
debate?
Like 5 minutes.
What?
I
got to
speak
to you. Oh, my bloody bags. Oh, my. Sorry.
So what?
Let's check out this.
Where am I standing?
Behind the car.
Oh yeah, Captain Bloodfire here needs no introduction.
Fire today.
His blood is on fire.
That's right.
It's called Captain Bloodfire, isn't it?
That's right.
Is it Mike? Can you see the mic? Aki, can you see the mic? One. Yeah. Alright. Let me put it here, Captain. Okay, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brothers and sisters, dear friends. We're at Salam Corner. Captain, we're at Salam Corner, yeah? What that means is, I don't shout over you, you don't shout over me.
Right.
We don't insult, we just listen to each other. Right. If we disagree, we agree to disagree. Yeah? So I'm going to give it to you. You believe I misrepresented you, or I lied or something like that.
Yeah.
So it's your right, express yourself what I lied about.
Okay. In your latest video, the video you did, you said that I said that Aisha was an adult. I actually said that he was waiting for her to be big enough to put it in. What I meant by it was his penis. The analogy I was using was that a baby, when she's a baby, you cannot put your dick inside a baby. Too small.
Can we not use those terms?
I won't use those terms, but that was the terms I was using. I'm trying to be. You cannot put your penis inside of a baby. It's too small. But as a baby goes, what? Let's say 3 years. That baby will grow big enough for that to occur. I wasn't justifying the fact that he did sleep with a 9-year-old. I was saying that he was waiting for her to be big enough to put it in. And according to Islamic jurisprudence, that's what happened. They would have either been fighting, which is the term they use, according to Islamic jurisprudence, it would have been fighting. They would have done that either before they had a period or before they were old enough for them to have sexual intercourse with them. But they tended to marry early. That was the point he was stressing. So in your video...
You tend to marry early?
Muslims in general, but I'm talking about during the time.
There were different people. There was a Roman Empire, there was the Persian Empire. Was it only Muslims that married young, or was it in general people?
I'm not talking about them. I'm talking about this situation that happened. In your video, you said quite clearly that I said that Aisha was an adult. This is the terms you use, and you can watch your video again. In fact, everybody watch it again. I did not say in that video that Aisha was an adult. I was simply using the terms she's waiting for her to be bigger. You can construe bigger how you want, but the term I meant was she was 9 years old. Bigger, it does not mean in the way that you think it means. It meant for me that I was saying that she's waiting until, no, he was waiting until she gets to a point where she's big enough to put his feelings on her. That's what I meant. So you lied about me in that term. And you even, when you first uploaded this video, Ali, and I noticed it, you said that I justified raping the Bible. That's what you said, and then you corrected it. So I'm glad you at least saw that.
How did I correct it?
You changed the title from God admits as raping the Bible, or God justifies raping the Bible. You changed that to God messes up. So you changed it.
No, the reason I changed it is not because I was lying. It's because I believe the title would be a bit more catchy. That's the reason.
Don't believe you're lying about me?
No, because the thing is, you know when I showed you in the book of Zechariah?
Right.
The book is actually this chapter of Zechariah. So when it's ordered, for example, like, let's establish something, yeah? Do you believe that Jesus is God?
Yes.
Okay. So therefore, Jesus is God always?
Yes, he always has been.
He always has been, okay. Yes. So is Jesus the same God that stipulated in the Old Testament, in the book of Samuel, chapter 15, verse 2-3, to go to the Amalekites? Yes, we agree they were very bad people. They're doing really bad stuff. Worshipping other idols, yeah?
Not only that, they sacrificed their own children to a god named Molech. Basically, what they would do is they heat up that god and basically stick their babies onto it and burn them alive.
Okay, so...
God, through that process, had to basically teach the children of Israel. And if the children of Israel did this themselves, in Exodus, the children of Israel did this themselves. They decided to sacrifice their babies. They committed orgies. So God himself, he punished them. And the way he punished them was he gave the Amalekites their hand. This is what I'm going
for. When you say God, do you mean Jesus?
Can you say Jesus? The reason why I use the term God, because that's the term that was used in the Old Testament. If you want to be like on the point, like with semantics, Jesus is nowhere found in the Old Testament. That's a fact.
But we agree that he was God.
But this is why I'm using the term. I agree he's God. I know he's God.
Okay, so
that's why I use the term God. I'm not using the term Jesus, because the term Jesus is New Testament. It's not Old Testament. Jesus was the angel of the Lord in the Old Testament, but he wasn't God in the New Testament. You see what I'm saying? So he wasn't God in the New Testament.
Okay, but what I'm saying is, Jesus was God all the time.
He was God all the time, but I'm not using the term God for that. I'm not using the term Jesus for that time, because one, it's unfundamental. Jesus wasn't around at that time. The word Jesus, the name that the angel of Lord, that the word of Lord took on, that name Jesus was not used at that time.
Okay, but let's suppose the name wasn't used, but was it the same person?
There's three persons, the same
divine being. In the Old Testament and the New Testament.
God did, yes.
Therefore,
I believe Jesus.
I'm going to prefer to use Jesus.
You can't use Jesus, because that's
why.
That's not, bro. Let's be consistent. That's not consistent. If you use the term Jesus in reference to that, Jesus wasn't, the term Jesus, the word Jesus, wasn't used for the angel of the Lord at that time. So you're using a term that wasn't around talk about that time. Yeah, it doesn't work.
No, but to me, it seems like when bad things happen in the Bible, he's called Yahweh, your God. When good things happen, he's called Jesus. Yeah?
No, I'm sorry, I don't know where you're getting that from. Again, you're looking at the Bible as if it's one body of literature. No, the Bible is different books about different occasions at different times and different covenants.
Okay.
So the covenant of the children of Israel, as you've described, the covenant of children of Israel, that has nothing to do with the covenant I use now. I'm solely New Testament. My faith is not based upon the Old Testament. The Old Testament has nothing to do with my faith, and it's not fundamental to my faith. The point you're using is that, oh, Jesus is God, and I believe Jesus is God as well. But I also believe, using the term Jesus in an Old Testament context does not work, because it is not consistent, right? And the argument's petty, Ali. Because if you're going to use the argument that there are passages in like, let's say, 1 Samuel 15, if you're going to take that out of context and just say, oh, well, this doesn't matter, and just take it out of context and say, oh, this says killing this. Let's go to Surah 9:29. What does it say? Surah 9:29. What does it say? It says, fight the unbelievers.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does. just bites the unbelief.
Let's go to.
Go to.
Captain, so that's over.
99.
Yeah, but this is okay. Okay, it says fight those people of the book. Yeah?
What translation? Because the translation of what is quite the unbelief.
No, no, no. When you say unbelief, it's yes, they, in that general term, they are. But the Christians and the Jews are close to us. But we still, we're not, we can come to this, but that's not my main point. What I'm trying to say is...
No, no, but that's my point. If no, you're no, going to take things out of context,
no, no, but this is,
I can easily take that out of context and say, that commissions you to fight all unbelievers
no, no, no,
all the time.
No, it doesn't.
Right.
No, it doesn't.
Well, then don't take passages out of context and do what you're accusing me of doing right now. Because you're going to accuse me of taking without context, aren't you?
No, but I'm repeating again. You believe
Let's
Jesus,
be consistent.
Jesus, yeah, but that's what I'm asking for. You're saying Jesus is the God. He's been God all the time. If he's been God all the time, then the title... Let's
yes, but the title Jesus would not be used for Yahweh at that
okay,
time.
But
so let's be consistent.
Still, is he the... Okay, look. He wasn't called Jesus back then. But was he the same God? Yes or no?
Yes, I just
okay,
said
Okay, one second.
That. All
I you're telling
said
me,
he was God.
You're telling me the names are different. So you're saying Ali, he was not called Jesus then, but he's called Jesus now. I'm saying irrelevant. If he was called...
It is relevant, bro, because I wouldn't go to your Quran and say,
okay,
oh, well,
right,
there's
okay.
passages here, and I'll just abrogate them wholly and
okay,
say,
okay,
oh,
can
this
I,
is
okay,
what
can
we're
I,
used to
this. Can I do this? Can I do this? Can I go and shoot someone? And then change my name and go, my name's John now.
That's not the argument for it, though. I'm not saying that God did not do those things. I'm not
okay,
saying he did
that's
all
what I'm
those
saying.
Things.
So did Jesus
but
do those things?
You have to answer. I'm not talking about Jesus.
Did he do it?
The term Jesus, we have to be consistent. The term Jesus, stop running around. The term Jesus was not used at that time. So if you're going to be consistent, we have to be consistent to the Old Testament covenants and Old Testament laws that apply to that time. There's a lot of things that I don't do now, like circumcision, like sacrificing to the Lord, like incense, like other stuff, even laws that were subjected due to the Israelites, which we do not do now, such as like divorce laws like that Jesus himself came down and fulfilled.
Okay,
those laws we are not under. We are under solely, me as a Christian, solely I am under, you can maybe go to the Jews, but solely I am under the New Testament and Jesus Christ, the
okay.
covenant made with Jesus Christ.
Okay.
So going to that does not attack me. If anything, it attacks the Jews because they're the ones who are solely Old Testament. Yes,
no,
they
no,
believe
listen,
in Old Testament
the point, laws. The point is this here, we're looking at someone, let's suppose there's someone who has committed a crime, yeah? And their name has changed now to before. So before they
You're
were
You're assuming that he committed a crime.
Can I finish? Where
was
no,
the
no,
crime?
No, I'm just saying, let's assume a what? Crime was committed, yeah? This person's new name is Matthew. Before he was called David, is he the same person that committed the action?
What is your point, Andy?
No, but answer my question.
Yes.
He was David 10 years ago, he's Matthew now. Is he the same person who has committed the crime?
You're conflating that God committed
no,
any
no,
crime.
I never said that. I'm asking you.
I want to ask you this
I'm
question.
I'm talking about
no,
David.
No, no, no. I
want
to ask you this question.
Why are you not
be consistent.
My
be consistent.
I'm trying to tell you to be consistent.
If God kills somebody,
yeah.
Is that right or wrong?
No, God can do whatever pleases his majesty.
Right.
He can do that.
So if God has foreknowledge of all things,
yes.
All things in and outside of existence, yes. And he knows in full foreknowledge what is going to be the outcome of every situation,
yes, yes.
Does he have the right to wipe out
yes,
an entire
yes,
nation?
Yes, yes.
If he knows
he
that nation
yes.
will
he has in the Quran.
Will, no,
has,
1 minute.
He has,
will fester and grow into
yes,
an even
yes,
more
yes,
wickedly
yes.
Because he did that in the Quran, right?
Yeah.
So I'm wondering, but the point I'm trying to make is for that time, for that covenant, at that time, those laws were for God's purposes to rid the world.
I'm not saying that. Hear me out, Captain.
You're not hearing what I'm
Captain,
saying.
Captain, I'm hearing you. I'm saying, I'm not telling you. Because if I said I'm shooting myself in the foot, Allah destroyed nations in the Quran. I'm not, that's not my point. I'll be a hypocrite.
Right, but nations include women and babies.
No, yeah, but that's what I'm saying. God can do that. The difference between the Quran and the Bible is that in 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 2 to 3, it's a war ethic. They're telling you to go to Amalekites. Allah's not destroying nations. Now, I want to ask you a simple question. If you're going to reject the Prophet Muhammad and the Quran and Islam based on your subjective morality that you have today, and you're going to call the Prophet, oh, he wasn't a prophet because he had bad morals, you can say bye-bye to
no,
Jesus.
Really,
you know
no, really, no, because
you.
Your Prophet...
Let me tell you,
your Prophet is the best example for all mankind for all time.
I never said he's not.
Moses is not the best example
no,
of mankind.
I'm talking about Jesus. I don't
None of them.
Moses.
No,
Captain,
bro,
Captain,
bro.
The example I'm using,
New Testament.
Captain,
if you can move
to
the New Testament, that would be nice.
I am
because the New Testament is where it's at.
No,
you
am.
Go into Old Covenants
I'm
and
not.
Talking about how Jesus God is a non-argument.
Captain, hear me out.
Be consistent.
Let me finish.
There are covenants.
Okay, let me finish. Yeah. The point is this. I'll repeat again. Your problem with the Prophet is he's a good role model for all kind or all times, yeah? If that's the case, you're saying, Ali, how do you justify the Prophet marrying Aisha? How do you justify him doing da-da-da-da-da? You're saying, I'm rejecting the Prophet as a true Prophet because of certain things he's done that I believe is not moral. If that is the case, you have to be consistent. What did you say?
Well, you're not being consistent because your Prophet isn't God.
I haven't finished. But that's my point. If a Prophet is going to be rejected of his prophethood because of so-called allegations of bad morals, if you claim
it wasn't allegations, it was Sahih al-Muslim and Sahih al-Bukhari.
You're not missing the point. You're twisting it and you're labeling it, yeah? Without seeing the full story. I'm saying if you're going to say to the Prophet of Islam, you are not a prophet because of bad morals, you have to say bye-bye to your God. Let me tell you why, hear me out. You have to be consistent. Because if the Prophet is not a prophet because of bad morals, if that's the case, let's go to the God of the Bible. New Testament, Old Testament. The point is this.
No, I'm sorry. Ali, you keep talking about...
I'm sorry. Can I finish?
You keep...
But Captain, I'm making a case.
You're making non-arguments. You're making non-arguments.
Captain, come on.
Because I've already explained to you that we are under New Testament,
Captain,
New Covenant. And you're going back, bro. You're going back to the Old Testament.
Okay, let me ask my question. You answer.
Well, then stop conflating things that you don't understand.
If I am, then when you speak, I'll listen and you can dismantle, yeah? Now, the point is this. Jesus in the Old Testament, yeah? Okay, has said some stuff which he's saying that Jesus is now a new person. He's changed his mind. He's a new, bright new person.
I didn't say he changed his mind.
One second.
You're ignoring
Captain,
what I'm saying again. You're lying again.
If I'm lying, you have your own time. Listen to me. Jesus stipulated rape in the book of Ezekiel. I can't remember. Yeah, and then he also ordered the children of Israel to go to the Amalekites, kill men, women, children, babies, and donkeys. Yeah. And there is many things he stipulated in the Old Testament. This is the same Jesus, same God. If you're going to say bye-bye to the Prophet Muhammad, you need to say bye-bye to your God. And I'm asking you, show me anywhere in the Quran that tells us Muslims to go to a land and kill men, women, children, babies. Anywhere in the whole Islamic text.
Right, I'm trying to explain the context, but you're not listening. So the context of that, of those passages, because you tend to jump, you go to one verse and say, well, this is the whole meaning. Now, the context of the passages before that in Exodus, the Amalekites actually killed off the women and children of the children of Israel. This you can look in Exodus itself, all right? First Samuel 15, you've got to understand the context of that as well. It's you don't understand. God in Genesis, go to Genesis 15, 16. In Genesis 15, 16, it says, I'll give them 400 years. He's talking about the Amalekites. Give them 400 years until their iniquity has increased. After that, judgment will come. God is allowed through people, for humans, to pass any judgment he wants to, including wiping out that generation. And if you're going to say that God wipes out generations, as they do in the Quran, if you're going to say that that's wrong, then you might as well say goodbye to your God, because it's, according to Surah 929, he commissions unbelievers to be killed.
Men, women,
and he also says, he also, unbelievers can be men,
no,
women,
no.
Or children.
I'm sure where it says men, women, and children.
Unbelievers can be women, children.
No, it doesn't say that.
So you're saying that unbelievers can't be women?
No.
So your God's inconsistent?
No. Because it tells you very clearly that you can't kill men, women, and children. In Surah Baqarah, verse 190 to 194, it says clearly, you said that the Amalekites were killing the children of Israel. In the Quran, Allah doesn't tell us, our teachers are not the unbelievers. Because if someone kills my child, I'm not going to go and kill their child. It doesn't work like that.
Right, you're still being inconsistent.
Can you show me where it says kill?
No, I'm sorry. Fight the unbelievers is so vague.
No.
You can literally go. Listen, if I was a Muslim and I saw fight the unbelievers. Sorry, 1 minute. If I was a Muslim, I saw fight the unbelievers. I read that in his passage and I thought, well, might as well go and fight the unbelievers.
Exactly.
I go and bomb.
That's what ISIS
and
do.
I can go and bomb.
They read one word.
Hold on 1 minute, bro. And I as a Muslim, I'm saying as a Muslim, theoretically, as a Muslim, would go and blow up a house full of people. I'm still fighting unbelievers, am I not?
No.
Under whose law?
But we've done is what ISIS do, Abu Bakr Baghdadi. This is what these people, the Anjem Chaudhry, why do we confronted their followers?
Because they read your books.
Because they have the same.
No, because they read your books.
I read the
book. They read
why
your
don't
book.
I read the book. Muhammad Ajami is a book.
They read your books.
Why don't we do
they
it?
They read your books and take it literally. And there are.
Why don't we do it?
And you ignore it or you try and cover it up. Just like you cover up Age of Aisha. Even though that was wrong and I was sick and that was disgusting. You're told your prophet.
The prophet married Aisha at 6 and consummated at 9. I've got no problem with that. I've done videos.
Yeah, I know you've got no problem with that.
I spoke to an English gentleman on my video. It's got nearly 400,000 views. He himself said. That makes sense because it's context. You are coming in with a bias. I'll repeat
what
again.
Context, bro?
Well, I've said
what's
that.
The context?
Listen.
You're telling me that Abu Bakr had the right to sell out his daughter to his prophet just for the sake of getting some money.
Okay,
can you
substantiate that, please? Can you bring me hadith that says that Abu Bakr sold it for money?
Bro, Abu Bakr, according to your
can you show me, please? Okay,
I'm saying according to your you get them yourself.
There it doesn't exist.
It does exist.
Okay, show me, please.
According to your sources, Abu Bakr was the one who gave Aisha, who gave Aisha into marriage to the Prophet. Am I lying or not? I'm lying or not?
You're lying.
Are you listening to what
you're lying,
I'm saying?
You're lying.
Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr is the father of Aisha.
Captain.
Yes or no?
You can't call yourself Captain.
Abu Bakr is the father. Can you stop talking to me? Abu Bakr is the father of Aisha, correct or not?
Yes.
Right. So he would have had a hand at letting the Prophet marry her. Am I right?
But you said for money.
Bro, at that time, and this is the arguments I've heard from Muslims. Wait and listen to me. This is the arguments I've heard from Muslims. They said at that time, each family married another for financial purposes. At that time, that's what would have happened. So Abu Bakr would have allowed the Prophet Muhammad to marry for them to join houses for financial purposes. This is what I've heard from Muslims.
Okay, can you bring Hadith? I don't care what. So I've got some Muslims coming saying that we can kill all the unbelievers like you. Bro, but we don't follow him.
Bro, so but your book evidence? Says kill all the unbelievers.
Show me,
so let's
please.
Not get into that.
Show me, please.
What, your book saying kill all the unbelievers?
I repeat again. In the book of Amalekites, it says a direct order. Kill men, women, children, babies. Show me any verse in the Quran.
Right, but I've waited for you.
The Islamic
literature
that says the following.
To show me where that applies to me now.
Men, women, children,
babies. Because you're not being consistent. That does not apply to me now. That verse, 99, that does apply to you now.
It's Jesus who legislated
it. Applies to you now, but it doesn't apply to you now.
It's Jesus who legislated it, man.
And what did Jesus say in Luke 22?
So you have to say bye-bye
to Jesus. What did Jesus say throughout the Gospels?
What did he say?
Love thy neighbour with all your heart and love thy God. Love thy neighbour as yourself and love thy God with all your heart.
Oh, so is that
those are the two greatest commandments given to Christians.
And what did
I am
do
not
today?
Under the old covenantal laws. The old covenantal laws were given at that time. Your argument is folly. It's a non-argument because you cannot use it against a Christian. You can only use it against a Jewish person because they believe in the old covenant. I don't believe in the old covenant. I don't believe that saves. It's the law of faith that saves. And that's that law of faith under Christ that saves. Not the old laws.
Okay.
And you're going to show me.
Okay, is it Jesus speaking?
Yeah? I know what you're showing me.
Okay, don't misunderstand why I have come. I did not come to abolish the law. So he means he hasn't come to abolish the law.
No, he didn't come to abolish
the law. Of Moses or the writings of the prophets. So what do we understand firstly? He has not come to abolish the law. He said, I've come to abolish the law. He's right.
That doesn't mean that we're under that law.
Let Jesus talk. No, I came to accomplish their purpose. I tell you the truth, until heaven and earth disappear, not even the smallest detail of God's law will disappear until this purpose.
Now go to Luke 22. Do you know how covenants
work? I'm asking, why are you going to Luke, bro?
The reason why I'm going to Luke is because Luke explains it fully.
Captain, now listen to you. Let me listen
to
you. So if you ignore the least commandments, listen. If you ignore the least of the commandments,
you'll be least in the kingdom of heaven. I've read it already.
You memorize this, subhanAllah, yeah?
Does it say that you'll be saved?
But
does it say
anyone that salvation who obeys God's laws and teaches them will be called
Does it say that salvation is due through the old laws?
One second.
Yes or no? Ali, you've been speaking for a long time. Yes. Does it say that the old laws are for salvation purposes? Yes or no? Does it say that?
If it says at the end of it that you will be called the least,
least in the kingdom of heaven. You'll still be in the kingdom of heaven even though you've done all those things.
But anyone
you've destroyed your own argument.
It's not night.
You've just destroyed your own argument, Ali.
But anyone who obeys God's laws and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven, yeah? So you'll be called great in the kingdom of heaven if you abide by them.
And less in the kingdom of heaven. Who receives the kingdom of heaven according to the Bible?
Those who obey the law.
Ali, be consistent. Who receives the kingdom of heaven according to the Bible?
It says here that
those who believe in Christ. John 3:16 says those who believe in Christ will be saved. So that's still salvific. It's not about breaking a law. If it said there,
what does this mean?
If it said there you will not be saved, then
mean?
I would agree with you.
No,
but nowhere
does
it say that you will not be saved.
No, but it says, look, the last two sentences. Yeah?
Least in the kingdom of heaven.
Look, so you will be called. Look, so if you ignore, look, this is Jesus,
least in
not
the kingdom
me.
Of heaven.
So if you ignore the least commandment
ignorant,
and teach
man.
Others to do the same, so meaning if you ignore it, like he's ignoring it, and he's telling people, listen, man, that's the Old Testament, forget it.
No, again.
You will be called the least
again,
in the kingdom of heaven.
You don't even know the law. You don't know the law.
It's Jesus, not me. I'm reading Jesus for you.
He's talking. Guess who's who is he talking
to? But
anyone
who obeys God's law.
Who is he talking to at that time?
He
is talking to the Jews. He's speaking to the Pharisees. The Pharisees believed in the old laws.
Yes,
right?
So he's coming.
So they kept the covenants. That's why they went to stone the adulterous woman.
So why
because that
Jesus?
Was their law.
I don't understand. So how are you accepting
Jesus? I accept
Jesus
more than you because you didn't read the whole passage.
Jesus has said rape. You didn't read the whole passage. Look at Ali Dawa.
You did not read the whole passage.
Can
what does it say? What does it say?
It's
Ali Dawa. Stop being a troll,
Captain,
can we talk?
But you're not letting me talk.
But you're not letting me talk
okay,
either, bro.
You talk, let me know when you finish. I'm holding the mic for you.
Oh, I'll give you all the mic. Hold on a minute. All right, let's read this in this context. But anyone who obeys God's laws and teaches them will be called great in heaven. Let's read before that. So if you ignore the least commandment and teach others to do the same, you will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. Right, these laws are not salvific then. How can they be? If it's the case that those laws are salvific, that means that anybody who breaks one part of this law would not receive the kingdom of heaven at all. But this law, this says clearly that anyone who does least of these laws will be least in the kingdom of heaven. Are you getting what I'm saying? Is anybody getting what I'm saying?
So what's the reward for kingdom of heaven if Jesus is saying that?
So it means that something else is the salvation.
What is that?
Jesus Christ. John 3:16. Read it properly.
So you know when he says, anyone who obeys God and laws teaches them will be great. And what does he mean by great? Like what reward would you get for obeying them? Why is he saying that? Why is he trying
great, to... You could always great in popularity, great in status. But it doesn't mean that those least in the kingdom of heaven do not receive the kingdom of heaven. The point is you're missing the kingdom of heaven bit.
Okay.
Why did it, Ali, answer me this question and be consistent. Why does the person who does the least of it, why would the person who does the least of these commandments still receive the kingdom of heaven? In what way?
You mean the least.
Yeah, but why would they, least in the kingdom of heaven.
Yes.
Right, why would they still be allowed to be in the kingdom of heaven?
No, because they believe in Jesus.
Right.
As a savior, yeah.
So what is the soul for salvation? What is the soul for salvation?
Salvation is for you to believe in Jesus.
Yes, the salvation.
Said, I know, I accept
is for
that.
You to believe in Jesus.
My point is this, right. I'm saying, isn't Jesus the same person who taught things that you are disturbed about in the Old Testament? That's why you keep saying, forget the Old Testament, it's not Jesus, it's God, it's Yahweh. I'm saying,
but you've
isn't
ignored
this the same
bro,
Jesus?
Bro,
Captain,
been,
listen to me, man. Listen to me.
Relax.
Relax, man. I'm saying very simply, yeah? Let's suppose arguments say what you're saying is right. Your salvation is with Jesus. I'm saying, isn't Jesus the same God of the Old Testament who legislated things that you claim the prophet did, which the prophet didn't, but even if he was to, let's say, argument's sake, the prophet did that, argument's sake, yeah? What your God, not prophet, God, your Lord, your God, commanded the rape of women. He commanded the smashing of, get the babies and smash them.
The translation is rubbish.
Let me finish.
You're talking about Zacharias.
Let me finish. Jesus commanded things that you would run a mile from. How are you accepting him as your God?
The reason
but
why.
Telling us Muslims that your prophet is
the
not
reason
prophet
why.
Because he did certain things.
The
that
reason
not
why
consistent.
Is because
please.
That example, those things that happen, they have a context, and that context applies to that time.
So, context of
rape. I do not have to do those things. If you just go to Luke 22,
are you justifying rape?
I'm not justifying rape.
At that time,
rape.
Jesus ordered for the rape to happen of certain women.
It means ravage. And that expressive language is used. Hebrews at the time, who would have
don't
wrote the Bible.
It.
1 minute, bro. Hebrews who would have wrote the Bible, because you got to understand, you're conflating the Quran with the Bible. We do not believe that the Bible is God's literal words in that sense. We don't believe that it's God's literal words. We believe that these people, during that time in Zacharias, they would have used expressive language. Like, there's passages in the Bible that say, go out and completely annihilate them. But then you find out
that
there's still Canaanites still living there. Yeah. So they didn't completely annihilate them, even though they were told apparently by God to annihilate them. This was the expressive language that was used of that time to express those things. And the Hebrews used that because those were people that write them. You gotta understand, the Bible is not the word of God like you think the Quran is the word of God.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you. At least you
have to no, it's the truth, because Jesus is the word of God. Read John 1:1. In the beginning was the word, and the word with God, and the word was God. You believe the Quran is an eternal book. I do not believe that at all.
Okay.
I do not believe the Bible is an eternal book. The Bible in itself is not fundamental to my salvation. You need to understand that.
Okay, once again.
You've gone back to Deuteronomy, even though I told you to go to Luke 22.
No,
be consistent.
You're missing the point here. The point is
you're
this,
missing the point.
Jesus is the God. This is where you get uncomfortable, and that's why you're
I'm not uncomfortable, mate. I'm
you
fine.
Know why, Captain? Because the God of the Old Testament, the God of the Old Testament, which is Jesus, has done some disturbing things which you can't accept.
I can't accept.
And because
it.
No, you can't. And you're changing. You're even saying the word rape is not rape.
I said it was rubbish in the Hebrew, bro. If you read the Hebrew, it's rubbish.
They
translated that.
There are
translators who will translate things wrong.
There are other words where it says, for example, when you go into war, you kill the men and take the woman who have not laid with another man, meaning virgins, for yourself. Yeah? This is a commandment from Jesus, the God of the Old Testament. How are you telling me that the Prophet Muhammad can't be a prophet?
Again,
because
you're
of
using
certain...
the
no,
term
answer
Jesus.
My question. How do you follow a God who has committed these atrocities in history? How do you follow him? Can you please tell me?
I'm asking you to explain to me what you consider atrocity. Is it
rape?
Atrocity? Is it
smashing babies?
Is it atrocity?
Children?
Is
and
it
donkeys?
Bro,
I don't know what the donkey did, by the way.
Is it?
Yeah, we don't know what the donkey did. You don't though, Captain. What did the donkey do?
They used to have bestiality at that time. This is why you need to read
the
context.
What was the donkey going to do? What did a baby do?
Bro, one minute. Let me talk. All right. Understanding the context of that time, you've got to apply that to the context of that time.
Okay, give me the context.
All right. The Amalekites of that time and the Israelites themselves of that time were sacrificing their babies. They were going out and murdering people and butchering them. God, in Genesis 15:16, said, I'll wait 400 years whilst their iniquity increases. Once their iniquity is done, so he gives them 400 years. And he warns them.
What? To fix up?
400 years to fix up their actions and to stop sacrificing their babies to a false god named Molech.
Yeah.
To stop doing all that. Yeah. Okay. He gave them 400 years. They did not listen, so he instituted judgment. Then he said to Joshua, all this is in your hands. So what he means by your hands is literally, he will give them up to he will give the Canaanites, the Amalekites, up to Israelites. And they were allowed then to go in and to kill them.
And the expressive, kill who?
Expressive language used, I'm being specific so I can, but you need to be patient.
Okay, kill who?
The expressive language used was used by the Hebrews at that time. This is not me making a judgment of it. Look it up yourself. It's what Hebrew done. They use expressive language like it will exterminate them all. We'll this and that. Just like if I say I completely annihilated you in the debate, does that mean I killed you?
No.
No, it doesn't. So there's context implied, and the context there is that they said they annihilated all of them, but they did not annihilate all of them.
So they didn't
They did kill them,
who?
But they didn't annihilate all of them.
No, okay, who did they kill? Can you just be specific?
The Canaanites, the Amalekites, and other groups were given into their hands.
What right? did they do with them?
Then they killed them. They
how,
killed
how? Men only?
No, they, no, women? No.
They didn't kill men.
They bro, understand the context first. Before that point, before that point, I'm trying to explain it to him. Before that point, way before that point, in Exodus. One minute, I'm trying to talk, man. In Exodus, the Amalekites went and killed off the children and the elderly of the Israelites.
Yeah, not Israelites.
That happened.
What did they
so
do?
God said to them, I'll enforce judgment on you. He says this in Exodus 12.
Okay, okay.
So God's already warned them of their actions.
No,
they still continue to do it.
You're right, 100%.
So God, being in his fullness of being and knowing all things and having full knowledge of all things, allows that happen. And honestly,
what did he do though? Look, I understand they were bad.
I understand. You're going to go to 1 Samuel 15
now. What did they do?
Look,
I understand the Amalekites were very bad. They were killing, worshipping the idols, sacrificing the children. They killed the children of Israelite. I'm with you 100%. What did God of the Old Testament, as known as Jesus, commanded them to do to the Amalekites?
Right, well, he commanded, he said before that, in Exodus, he says before that if you continue to do this stuff, I will bring judgment on you. That's what he says
judgment
to the Amalekites. The
judgment
was that the wrath that was supposed to be
happening.
What's
the wrath? Can you be
the wrath
specific?
Was 1 Samuel 15 to 16,
okay,
where they were given up to their hands.
Okay, how? Kill men? Did they kill men?
You're not being serious.
You know what? I don't like it. Let me be honest here. Look, I've listened to it.
I'm not dodging the car. I'm actually trying to explain.
You know what you're doing, bruv? You know, have you seen Matrix?
I'm not dodging.
Bruv, listen. Listen. This is what you're doing.
No, I'm not dodging.
Captain, look, I'm sorry, but seriously, this inconsistency. You're coming
there's
and
no
attacking us. You're a prophet. How can you be a prophet?
Because
raping
women. As I've said to you.
You're God ordered killing men, women, children, and babies.
Those old covenants, which
you
ignored. You've ignored those old covenants.
And that's
in which we are not part of.
Captain.
And if God orders to kill people, like your God did, your God wiped out nations.
Okay.
So if God orders to kill people, are they dying in literature or are they going up to him?
Captain, how could you tell me that my prophet is not a prophet because of a...
The reason why, because your God, your prophet Muhammad...
Your one is a God.
No, no, your prophet Muhammad is the best example for all time.
But we accept that. How do you accept your God as your God?
Because the law that in Luke that Jesus set down was a law for us in all time. The new covenant.
Captain, why are you not answering me?
The new covenant. Killed?
Okay.
So let's stay in the New Testament because I've explained to you the Old Testament.
Please, allow me to ask you 5 questions. Did Amalekite men get killed?
Yes, they did get killed.
Did the woman get killed?
Yes, they did get killed.
Children?
Yes.
Babies?
Everything in that passage is true. It's 100%. But expressive language, listen to what I'm saying.
How dare you come to me?
No, no, how dare you come to me? Because you just said that
God
orders nations to be killed. So if God orders nations to be killed according to your Quran, hold on. No, no, according to your Quran, God orders nations to be killed. So did your God kill babies and children?
I'm in audience.
Did your God order babies and children to be killed? One question, come on.
To the camera, bro, I'm done.
Did your God order nations to be killed or wiped out? Yes or no? Answer the question, Ali. What are you doing? You're just going to stare at me.
It's Don, Captain.
No, it isn't Don. Because you're not listening to what I'm saying.
You're
not being consistent. The new covenant is for me. My faith relies on, and I'm talking to you because I was talking to you while I was here. The new covenant is relying on me because that's the new covenant I'm supposed to follow. Right? The Old Testament God had reasons and rights in foreknowledge to do all he was doing for that time. But this period, that which requires my faith has nothing to do with that. In Luke 22, Jesus puts a new blood covenant, and new blood covenant is what I follow. But in your, according to your ideas, according to your Quran,
you better put this up.
Muhammad is an example for all mankind for all time. There is no new covenant. There is no new covenant. If Muhammad is that example, that means that a man has sex with a 9-year-old is your best example for all time. Done.
The point
I'm trying to make.
Yeah.
Next time, iron your shirt, man.
Yeah, I know what you need. Basically, the thing is with Muslims, they always use the argument in the Old Testament is for this covenant now. But that Old Testament has no holding or anything on this covenant now. This covenant now is in Luke 22 and other passages. It's for us Christians. Us Christians who follow that covenant. Using the example that the Old Testament orders this and that and not taking it into its fullness or into the fullness of what happened is irrelevant. You need to take it into its fullness and look at it in its whole before you even make justifications. And Ali cannot justify his prophet. His prophet is supposed to be a light for all mankind, yet had sex with a 9-year-old girl. There is no justification for that. However you want to look at it, all Muslims have to follow that prophet. And if they're following a man who's a paedophile who's done that, then they're following the wrong prophet. They're following the devil, they're not following the Lord.
Perfect.